Let's continue with LoRA. I will be using multiple LoRA models along with a 12GB model, which I forgot to show you in the previous video of the comfyUI playlist. I will search for Flux1.Dev FP8, and there are two results. I will open both. You can download the model from here. Now it looks better. If the 24GB model puts too much strain on your graphics card, then this is the model you should consider. By sacrificing a little quality, you can free up enough resources for your card to handle other tasks. This model will work on my 16GB card by utilizing the RAM, but it becomes very slow, and I don't think it's worth it. So I will be using Kijai's model. This model was uploaded 2 months ago, and I believe it is the best option for 12GB cards. Click to download. Go to the Models folder, then Checkpoints. I created a folder for Flux Dev FP8 models and save it inside. Also, just in case you have a server-grade graphics card, there is a heavier model by City96. In comfyUI, I open a new tab named after the model I just downloaded. My videos are aimed at beginners, and quickly creating a workflow will serve as a recap of what we covered previously. I will start with a K-sampler because it has the most connections. First, I will establish the model connection. I will double-click and search for Low Diffusion. This Low Diffusion model is necessary. Remember, Load Checkpoint was for SD 1.5 and SDXL. For the GGUF model, I use the UNet Loader, and for the NF4 model, I use the NF4 Quantization Checkpoint node, which is from a custom node by SilverOxide. I made the first connection, and the FP8 model I downloaded appears to be a UNet model. The second and third connections will be made using the Dual Clip Loader. The fourth connection is for the latent image. The empty latent image node can be connected here. The second and third connections are still empty. I will bring in the text encoder for the positive and negative prompts. I can connect this and simplify it. The negative prompt in Flux is not required, but the K-sampler needs a connection to be present. Before connecting the positive prompt directly, a Flux guidance node is required in between. This node is not necessary for stable diffusion models. I have completed the left side of the K-sampler. Now, moving to the right, the K-sampler takes latent images to generate an image, thus outputting a latent representation. Therefore, we need the VAE decoder to convert the image into pixel space. This VAE decoder requires a VAE, which can be obtained from the checkpoint, as we saw in the stable diffusion workflow. Here, the UNet model does not include a VAE, so I will use the load VAE node. Lastly, for the image connection, I will use either a preview image node or a save image node. I copied a prompt from the internet to check if it works. Let me look at the selected files. The 12GB UNet model is selected, then the below dual clip loader needs a T5 file and a clip L file for text encoding. Select the type Flux. The last file will be ae.safetinser. And the resolution should be 1024 pixels for best result. Now I should queue the prompt. The usage appears to be around 15GB, but I have read that people have successfully used it with a 12GB card as well. Let me know in the comments if it works. If it does, then this is the best model for a 12GB card. The result here does not look great, but it is functioning. The reason for the subpar result is that when using the Flux model, we bring the Flux guidance node, so we should keep the value of this guidance in K-sampler at 1. I will queue the workflow again. And the result looks fine. To add a LoRA, I will search for the LoRA loader node. I can copy and paste the node for two LoRAs. Adding both nodes to the workflow will allow us to use multiple LoRAs. I will create some space above and connect the model and clip. This is similar to what we saw in a previous video when using a single LoRA, so I will delete the existing connections. Then, I will make the connections with the second LoRA node. You can chain as many nodes as you want, but it becomes complicated for me after three LoRAs. Now that the workflow is ready, I will download a LoRA for Flux1.dev. After scrolling through the options, I decided to download the Alice LoRA. I will save it inside the LoRA folder, then the Flux.dev folder I created. Next, I will take the Fire Element LoRA. Back in comfyUI, I will refresh by pressing the letter R. Then, I will select the LoRA Alice Flux. In the second node, I will select the Fire Spirit LoRA. I will bypass these nodes in the workflow for now and try to generate an image without the LoRA. I took a prompt from the LoRA page and queued the workflow. Let me adjust the workflow to make it visible on the screen. If I change the control after generate from randomized to fixed and queue the workflow, I get this image. Now, because I had set the generate as fixed, the seed number will not change. Keeping all the settings and prompts as it is, the image generated by this workflow will remain the same. The program's output indicates that the prompt was executed because I clicked multiple times. If I click again, keeping it fixed will yield the same result. So, this is the image generated without LoRA. Now, I will generate an image with LoRA. And the result clearly shows the LoRA effect. Next, I will use the second LoRA for which I checked the trigger words. Bailing fire is the trigger word. I wrote a prompt, but it doesn't look perfect. I will activate the node and queue the workflow. I should have kept the LoRA strength at 50%. The total strength of all LoRAs should be 1. I do not like the result. Let me try adjusting the LoRA strength. Both are currently set at 50%. And I am using the same seed ID, so the character generated is similar to the previous image. I changed LoRA's strength. Control after generate is at random now, and the position is changed. The image generated is fine, but it can be better. You have to play with LoRA's strength and prompt to get the best as per your needs. If you need to use multiple LoRAs, I suggest getting the RGThree custom nodes. This will be useful and will help keep your workflow short and clean. The installation instructions indicate that you should clone the project. I will copy the clone command. We need to run this command inside the custom nodes folder. I will navigate to the custom nodes folder, type cmd, paste the command, and press enter. It's done. The instructions say to restart comfyUI. I did restart it, but the new nodes did not appear. There was an update button in the installed nodes, so I clicked that. After updating, I restarted again. I searched for Power LoRA, and this is what I was looking for. Now you can delete the existing LoRA nodes and use the Power LoRA node instead. Connect the model and clip as we did previously. Then click the Add button to add the LoRA. You can add multiple LoRAs here, and the LoRA weights can be adjusted from the right. You can enable or disable the LoRA from this switch. I will cue the workflow. The generated images are good, but the prompt needs some attention. Hope you got something from this video. Let me know if you are interested in making a LoRA.